Yeah, good afternoon, everyone. I am Tanvi Sharma, Associate Fellow Environment Education at STERI. I welcome you all to the webinar for students on Green Olympiad preparation organized as a part of Green Olympiad, which is a premier examination organized by STERI and also draws its linkage with UN Decade of ESD and Global Action Program. Green Olympiad was initiated in 1999, and since then, this initiative has seen a massive outreach. Participation in this examination is not only seen from schools in India, but also from schools in Australia, Bangladesh, Bhutan, Fiji, Indonesia, Iran, Kingdom of Bahrain, Kingdom of Saudi Arabia, Kenya, Kuwait, Mexico, DF, Nepal, Russia, Singapore, State of Qatar, Sultanate of Oman, United Kingdom, United Arab Emirates, United States of America, the Bahamas, Turkey, and Turkmenistan. With no further delay, I would request my team to kindly screen the tennis multimedia.
TERI was established in 1974, and in the last 5 decades of our journey, we have ensured sustainable, equitable growth for all. We started thinking much before others that for the security of the country, energy security is going to be one of the main things.
Distributed renewable energy will play a vital role in meeting India's goal of energy for all. This is evident in villages where solar energy has given rural women the opportunity to become entrepreneurs. Biomass gasifiers are powering cottage industries. Elsewhere, we have demonstrated the potential of the biomass gasifier to fuel even large industrial applications. Across several cities in India, we are driving campaigns to spread rooftop solar by aggregating consumer demand in large housing societies. On the other hand, we are helping utilities to manage demand better and eventually prepare for large-scale integration of renewable energy in the grid. Our energy system models help to formulate India's global climate commitments. They guide both government and industry on future pathways for energy and emission reductions. We believe that the intelligent use of resources should be at the heart of sustainable development. Be it reducing the energy use of small enterprises through energy efficient technologies and practices, or helping large industries bring down their water use, or handholding small entrepreneurs reduce their material use, or building capacity of municipalities to reduce and recycle waste. Our aim is to show that less can be more. We are steering the green building movement in India through our rating system for green buildings, Griha. From new housing societies to highway restaurants, airports, and upcoming townships, we are supporting citizens, developers, and local governments to build sustainable habitats. Amid deepening public concern on air pollution, we are developing city and state level emission inventories of air pollutants so that these become the basis for governments to start cleaning up our air. In several parts of India, our biotechnology products have cleaned polluted land. For example, the oil zapper, which is being used by all major refineries in India to treat oil spills on land. We closely monitor the ecological impact of climate change in hotspots across the country. For example, how glacial melt will affect downstream communities in the Indian Himalayas. Our climate modeling work informs both government and industry on the climate risks that India is likely to be exposed to in the coming decades. As these risks become strikingly evident on human health, we are fostering synergy among health, climate science, and policy experts to prepare for this emerging challenge.
We have totally banned hunting, fishing. We want to protect and preserve the biological diversity of this area.
Be it guiding forest communities to conserve their biodiversity and promote ecotourism, or helping farmers adopt improved plant varieties and practices, or helping communities improve livelihood from forest resources, or marine resources, or enabling tribal communities to source nutrition from home gardens. We help climate-stressed communities in diverse ecosystems restore their environment and yet improve their well-being. Our mycorrhizal technology, applied as a biofertilizer, has reduced the use of chemical fertilizers and improved productivity of crops across India and parts of North America and Europe. We're now pushing the frontiers of nanobiotechnology to answer some of the most critical questions that confront our environment.
Ready, go.
While creating knowledge all these years, we have strived just as hard to spread this knowledge far and wide. From using community radio to sensitize farmers in the Himalayan region, to engaging with students and teachers across cities and towns and villages of India, to gathering the world's finest leaders and thinkers at the World Sustainable Development Summit.
Equality, equity, and climate justice.
The Sustainable Development Goals of the UN are central.
The pandemic has exposed systemic fragilities and inequalities that threaten the basis of sustainable development.
We make every effort to take our message to every section of society. Now, into the fifth decade of our journey, we are a team of 1,000 professionals constantly raising the bar for ourselves to accelerate India's transition to a safer and sustainable future.
Thank you for this multimedia. With this very brief introduction about TERI, I would now request Dr. Livreen K. Kellon, Associate Director, Environment Education and Awareness TERI, to kindly deliver the welcome address. Over to you, ma'am.
Thank you, Tanvi. A very, very warm welcome to all the students who are a part of this webinar being conducted under Green Olympiad. Thank you so much for registering yourself for the examination. And thank you for being with us today to be a part of this webinar. This webinar is very important for you because this will show you the process of attempting the paper and also help you stay connected with Terry. There was a purpose behind showing you this film on Terry, because all by humble request to all the students, teachers, parent community, you are a part of Terry family. And what we wanted to show you through the film is that there are so many different ways in which Terry is moving forwards in transformative impacts in the society, especially in the field of sustainable development and environment. And while your children, while your students are at the school, you are a very important part of this complete journey. So examination is one part. Of course, you have to write the examination. You should know how you can attempt it. But a bigger portfolio is in store for you because you are now a part of Terry family. So automatically, you will come to know of different activities through which you can engage with Terry. I would like to tell you here, you know, you are all aware about the new education policy. And there are going to be several systemic changes in the entire conduct of the examinations in schools, in the curriculum formulation, in the evaluation monitoring techniques. Similarly, there are going to be several new subjects and topics and methodologies that will be added up to the existing school system. So while this is happening at a policy level, Green Olympiad in its own capacity has also tried to move from the issues of environment sustainable development to include skill education as one of our testing monitors. So when you are a part of Green Olympiad, you are a part of the broader policies and the shifts that are happening in the education system. So please remain connected with us. The students who are attending the webinar today, they have already registered for the examination. And you are our ambassadors to further promote this to other students who have not been able to register for the examination this year. Since we have closed the registration process, we cannot accommodate new requests. But over this year, you will see so many other activities in which the students can come forward and be a part of the program. So with this, I hand over to my team. And my message, my request, my wish for all of you is that do very well in the examination. And always remember that once you have registered, you are a part of any initiative, you are a part of the transformation. So all the best to all of you, and over to you, Tanvi. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, ma'am, for such motivating words. I would now request Ms. Taru Mehta, Fellow Environment Education and Awareness Terry, to kindly present an overview of Green Olympiad and the examination process. Over to you, Taru.
Thank you, Tanvi. I'm sharing my screen. So, Tanvi, just confirm if it is visible. Is it visible, Tanvi?
Not yet.
Share it again.
Is it fine now?
No.
No, we can't hear you.
Yes, it's coming now.
Yes, it's visible now, Taru.
Okay. Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome to all the teachers, parents, and students who are present here today. this particular webinar is for all of you to understand the work that Terry has been doing, and of course our flagship initiative Green Olympiad, and the process that will be followed for the examination. But before moving on to the slides, let me just request all of you that you should stop spamming the chat box. Yeah, because you know this platform is for questions and answers. If you have any doubts regarding the question paper, regarding the examination and anything, please write it on the chat box. There's no way we can stop you from chatting, but spamming is of course, you know, not appreciating and not welcoming. So please limit to only questions, and we would like to answer all your queries today, because later on when you come to us with questions and answers and emails and everything, so we will not be able to help you. So this webinar is organized for you to understand the processes, plus if you have any questions, we are here to help you all. So coming to the session on Green Olympiad, we have lots and lots of students this year who have registered with us. They are close to 30,000 students, and we are really thankful to all of you for believing in us for over the years and for registering on a regular basis. We would in the coming years encourage all of you to, you know, talk about your participation in the Green Olympiad to other students also, so that even they can participate from next year. So if you can see the screen, there is a picture from one of our very, very old schools, DAV Public School, Chandrasekharpur. And this is the picture, which is pre-COVID, when we used to have examination, which is a paper-based examination. So if there are students from DAV Chandrasekharpur who are attending the webinar today, welcome to you, and see the amount of, acceptance and the kind of love we give to children. It is really, really motivating for us also to see you participating and see you attend the webinar, plus attend the examination with utmost zeal and sincerity. So with this, we come to the second slide. Well, the context of Green Olympiad is that we try to inspire school fraternity, whether it is students, teachers, and the management, to take initiatives on environment and sustainable development within your campuses and also outside the campuses. And as part of Green Olympiad, we encourage students to appear for this multiple choice question quiz, such that we know where you all stand, what is the level of awareness you have, and it is a notion to even tell you how much you know about environment and whether there is a scope of any improvement when it comes to knowing your environment. The program started in 1999, and I'm sure most of you were born at that time. So Green Olympiad was also born in 99. And since then, we've been organizing this quiz program for students. Though every year we try to, you know, improve upon it, we try to add on new features. So currently in this year, we are doing it in two themes. I'm sure most of you are aware of it. It's environment and sustainable development, and the second theme is green skills. The idea is that we talk about environment to the youngest brigade, to the youngest citizens of the country, so that if change has to happen, if we have to think about environment improvement, then the knowledge should come from, the knowledge should reach you, such that when you grow up, you can take information, when you are in decision-making positions, you can take those decisions, keeping the environment and sustainability questions in mind. So the crux of the examination is that it tests environment knowledge of students through competition, through a quiz program. It enhances skills to promote self-learning. And when I say self-learning, I want to pitch here is that there is a quiz, there is an examination, and all of you must be studying for it. So please go through your curriculum very thoroughly, talk to your teachers about what needs to be learned, what needs to be understood when it comes to current affairs on environment, and that is how your self-learning will be promoted. Creating interdisciplinary knowledge, we do this because we try to do it in terms of, you know, having questions from your from subjects such as science, geography, and some bit of history, where we try to involve environment, social, and you know, current affairs on environment, because CBSE schools don't have a graded environment studies subject, which is why we are trying to bring in interdisciplinary nature. We are trying to bring in more subjects into one core theme of environment studies. And since there are lots of students who are from other boards and not CBSE, so it helps them also to come to a common platform and appear for the quiz. So these are some of the facts of Green Olympiad 2021-22. Dual themes are there. The examination, which will happen in November, is on environment and sustainable development, and the examination, which will happen in December, would happen on both the themes, environment and sustainable development, and green skills. So you would be aware that all the questions, all the students who have registered today know their dates, the time, and dates that you all have chosen. So just adhere to the communication that will soon come from Green Olympiad, the secretariat. The examination will happen online. It's an online medium, and the classes that we target are from class 4 to 12 across 4 difficulty levels. So level 1 is for classes 4th and 5th, level 2 is for classes 6th, 7th, 8th, level 3 is for 9th and 10th, and level 4 is for 11th and 12th. You would know students who have been participating in the quiz for a longer period of time, you would understand that the examination is endorsed by many government and UN bodies. So this year we have received endorsements from National Skill Development Corporation, CBSE, Kendriya Vidyalaya Sangathan, and Navodaya Vidyalaya Sangathan, United Nations, UNESCO, and some of the state education departments also. So when you get your e-certificates after the examination, you will see some of the very prominent logos there, and it just brings more credibility and more value to the certificate that you win. Direct engagement with teaching fraternity. In the month of September, we had done state level webinars for teachers, so your teachers were part of it. And today we are directly engaging with you through a webinar interface. Examination dates, as I said, it's between 10th to 15th of November and 6th to 11th of December. So these are some of the important links of the for you to refer. One is Green Olympiad website. You all would be knowing this link, terryin.org/olympiad. I will copy these links and share it on chat also. There was a registration tutorial also on YouTube, though the registration process, as Dr. Livdeen said, it's over. But through your teachers, we had shared a YouTube link for you to understand the registration process. There is a Facebook page of Green Olympiad. So if you are on Facebook, go and like the page. You will get all the regular updates on this particular page also. Now the last link, which is the most important link for your upcoming days, is the examination link. This link will be sent to you. It is being sent to you right now. As I'm talking to you, you know, confirmation mails are going to the students for the November examination. So you will be getting your examination link plus your username and password, and we will be talking more about it. And by 8th of November, if you don't get this link and an email from us, you should either call us or write to us at geo@terry.res.in. So we will be sharing all these emails and links to you in our chat box. So just refer to your chat. I saw a question wherein a student in the beginning itself was asking for prizes and incentives. So here comes the slide. The information is also on our webpage. So all the participants will receive e-certificates according to the individual performance. According to how much you have scored, you will get a certificate. I will also show a template of the certificate in my upcoming slides. Country and state winners will be awarded book vouchers. Yeah, and the cumulative figure is 1,50,000. Yeah, so country and state winners will be getting these vouchers. Trophies and medals will be awarded to students who score 100% marks. And let me tell you, we get students, 100 scorers like in hundreds. So trophies and medals would be going to these students. Teachers who have undertaken school registration. So you would understand that there were individual registration plus there were school registration. So teachers who have coordinated registrations of their students will also receive a e-certificate after the examination is over. Schools will receive a trophy for outstanding performance by their students. So this is also for school registration. We will see the cumulative figures of the marks that the students have received, and we will be deciding upon the on the school winners depending upon the score. Winners will also get volunteer opportunities at TERI. So these are some of the prizes that are enlisted right from the very beginning on the webpage. And today also we thought that it is a good idea to talk about it. Steps that are involved in appearing for the paper are that so this is the link. You click on this link. So what a screen will come, which will ask for your username and password. Once you click on that screen, you will be selecting your course. Then you would be attending the paper, rechecking the answers, and finally submission. So right now, what I will do is I'll try to show print screens of the pages of the link of the links once you open. So if you can see, if you once you click on the examination link which I shared in my previous slide, a screen like this will appear. So the username and password that you will get through the email, which is going from Green Olympiad Secretariat, you'll fill the details here. If you will fill any other form or you have forgotten the password, sorry, Green Olympiad Secretariat will not be able to help you. What you have to do is either mail it to us or call us on an immediate basis. So once you fill your details and log in, a screen like this will appear. So welcome to Green Olympiad will come, and then there are few instructions. And then you see that there is my course. So you have to click on the Green Olympiad online exam. There is no other option. So there's just one option under my courses. So once you click on Green Olympiad online exam, a screen like this will come in. Yeah. So here in general, you'll get some welcoming, remarks, some one-liner or two-liners. Then there'll be instructions, saying that, the examination is in English, the duration is so-and-so, and you can only attempt once, et cetera. So all those instructions will be there. And then whatever level you all have chosen during the registration, only that link will be active. Rest all other links will be dormant. So say, for example, if I am a level 2 student, if I am from any of the classes in 6th, 7th or 8th, my link will be the second link, which will be shown active here. So once you click on it, a screen will come like this, wherein, again, you can see Green Olympiad examination, level so and so, attempts allowed one, this, that, and then attempt quiz now. So you click on this encircled attempt quiz now. And then you move on to then you enter another page inside. They again ask you whether you want to start your attempt. Now, once you come at this stage, once you click on start attempt, your timer will start of 1 hour or 60 minutes. So you have to be very sure that you have to appear for this particular examination now. And also another thing is that the time and date that you all have chosen during the registration process, this examination will only open at that particular slot. There is no other way, there is no other time that you all can appear for the paper. So you start your attempt. Once you start your attempt, your questions will fall like this. Yeah, so one by one, you will get your questions and you can even navigate your quiz. So say, for example, if you want to go to any other number of questions, so you can say click on 35. So immediate, so you know, you'll come at the 35 question. If you want to go to the one to question number one again, so you can go back again. So you know, it's very friendly that way, and you can navigate your paper. And below the quiz, there is also a timer which is ticking. So you will get 60 minutes for this quiz. There are 50 questions, and timer will be clicking, will be ticking once you start your attempt to the paper. So you will go through all the questions, and the moment you come to question number 50, here is where you where it says finish attempt. Yeah, so you either click on this, or if you want to go back or navigate, you can do that also. But once you click on finish attempt, this slide will appear, the first slide, wherein you can again see whether you have answered the questions or not answered the questions. So while I was taking print screens of this, I have not appeared for the paper. So see, you, so I was getting not yet answered, not yet answered. So you can see the status. But when you answer the questions, answered will be coming here. And you can again cross check here. And then you can see in the second slide what is mentioned. Return to the attempt, so much time is left. The attempt must be submitted by Monday so and so. This is the time which is mentioned, because that is the time when your slot will automatically get over. So once, so if you want to go back, you can go back, or else submit all and finish. So once you submit all and finish, the screen will again ask for a confirmation of submitting the paper, whether you want to submit it or you've just done it by mistake. So there are different, you know, checks and balances while you are clicking on your screen, just so that we don't miss out on any scores, any questions, any answers that you want to give. Once you submit this screen, the final screen, screen number 10, is that you get a summary of your attempt. And you know, you can read here, it says finished and you know, submitted on so and so date. Yeah, so this roughly talks about how the examination portal will work, where you want to, where you all have to click, and what you can expect on your screens when it comes in front of you. Yeah, so these are few general instructions. Total number of questions are 50. It is same for both the tests, whether it is in November or in December. Both the examination sets have 50 questions. The time duration given is 60 minutes. There is no negative marking. Each question carries 2 marks. Certificate of distinction is 80% and above. Certificate of merit is between 60 to 79. And to the rest of the students, we will give certificate of participation. Okay, and the other prizes that we talked about, that remains the same. What are the post-examination procedures? So after the examination is done, you're done with your submitting of paper and all, what will happen is that we will be tabulating your scores and preparing for your e-certificate. So most likely by 5th of December, the November examinees would be getting their certificates, and by 5th January, the December students would be getting their certificates. So these are the dates. Dispatch of awards to winners of different categories. So physical awards, the medals, the trophies, and everything would happen once all the examination is over. Once the December paper is also over. So we will do the dispatch for both the examinations together. and we will be launching Green Olympiad 2022 in April 2022. So, to our announcements on the website as well as on our Facebook page, and you know, you will come to know the information that we would want to share. Thank you. I am looking at a lot of questions and queries and comments. So any questions, you could, there is a separate Q&A session after after the session of quizzing. And right now I will be reading all the chats that have come right now, and we would be answering your queries one by one. Okay. And any questions you have, please write on the chat box, and please don't spam the chat box. Thank you so much. I hope I have made myself clear, and I wish all of you the very best for the examination. Over to you, Tanvi.
Thank you so much, Karu, for explaining about the examination process in such details. We have a lot of questions. I'm sure you'll also be just answering them in the chat box, and we will get back to the questions after the next session. So with this, I would request Ms. Shabana M. Kazi, Fellow Environment Education and Awareness Terry, to kindly just do the quiz on environment, sustainable development, and green skills. Over to you, Shabana. We can't hear you, Shabana.
Can you hear me now?
Yeah, we can hear you now.
Yeah, okay. Thank you. Very good afternoon to all of you. Really glad to be here, and I'm sure you all are looking forward to this session, because this is going to be giving you an idea of the questions that you would be getting during the Green Olympiad examination. Okay, so just very quickly, I'll give you a structure of how we have this quiz. We have level one students who have joined us for level one, level two, level three, and level four. So the quiz is going to be as such that we're going to have few questions on the environment, which is section one for level one, and then on green skills as section two for level one students. Okay, so similarly, we're going to have both these sections for the level two, level three, and level four. Okay, you can type out your answers in the chat box. Okay, so I'll start sharing the screen. Just tell me if you are able to see it.
Yes, we can see, Shumana.
Can see it? Okay.
Okay.
So, sorry.
Slideshow. Can you put it in the slideshow?
Yeah. Now, is it better?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Fine. Okay. So, do let your answers come in thick and fast, because I'm not going to be waiting for too long. Okay. So let's begin. So as I said, this is for level one and on the environment section. Okay. So the first question, here you go. A village is a place where members of a community are involved in primary activities such as dash to earn their living. So you have four options. First one is baking, farming, banking, teaching. So these are all for our young students from class 4 and 5. Any guesses? Are we getting any answers in, Tanvi?
Yes.
Okay. So the correct answer over here is farming. Okay. So let's go on to the second question. Just a minute. Okay. This type of waste is biodegradable, and it commonly includes leftover food, fruit, vegetable peels, and flower trimmings. This waste can be classified as, so your options are chemical waste, organic waste, industrial waste, and e-waste. So what do you think the right answer is?
Most of the students are typing B.
Okay. Yeah, that's right. Okay, so we'll go on to the next question. Uh, Tanvi, any idea how to remove this, this dialog box that is coming in front of my screen? So unable to.
Could be the chat, maybe, Shivana.
Okay. Okay, just a second. I'm just trying to figure it out if I'm able to get. Okay, the wastewater generated from homes, restaurants, and offices is known as, your options are sink water, sewage water, effluents, and domestic wastewater. So which is the right answer over here?
Students are typing B.
Okay, great, great. Okay, so that is the right answer indeed. We'll go on to the next question. Which biodiversity rich country is gifted with the great Amazon forest? So your options here are South Africa, South America, Madagascar, and United States.
Shivana,
so which is the right answer?
We can't see the next slide.
Slide has not changed.
Oh, really? It has changed on my screen over here.
Now, can you do it again for the question four? Go back. Come back to four.
Now?
Changing. No, no change.
Yeah,
has it changed?
Okay. Now it's okay.
Okay. Okay. So the question was, which biodiversity rich country is gifted with the great Amazon forest? So your options here are South Africa, South America, Madagascar, and United States. So the right answer is, I'm sure you all will get this correct, South America. Okay. Yeah, okay. Yeah.
Yeah.
Let's go on to the next one. Yeah, I can see it. Yeah. Good. Let's go on to the next one. Okay, so this is the last, I think, question on this section. When is the International Biodiversity Day celebrated every year? On 20th of March, on 22nd April, 22nd of May, or on the 5th of June? So which is the right answer? You can type out your. Okay. So the right answer is C, 22nd of May. Okay. Now let's go on. For the same level, we'll go on to the section two, which will have questions on green skills. So remember that this is just giving you an idea of the sort of questions and the difficulty level that you will face during your exam. Okay. So these are just tentative questions based on which you can prepare yourself similarly. So coming to the first question, knowledge, abilities, values, and attitudes needed to live in, develop, and support a sustainable and resource efficient society are known as dash. Okay, so your options over here are life skills, environment consciousness, sustainable development, or green skills. So what is the right answer over here? Yeah, exactly. It is green skills. Okay. The next question. Which policy in India links sustainable development to improved employability and productivity? Okay. So your questions, your options over here are National Mission on Sustainable Habitat. The second option is National Policy on Skill Development and Entrepreneurship. C is National Mission for a Green India. And the last one is Swachh Bharat Abhiyan. Okay, so which is the right answer over here? Okay, I don't think we're getting this right. Yes, it is B, National Policy on Skill Development and Entrepreneurship. Okay. So that closes the level one section, and we'll go on to level two, section one, which is on the environment. Okay. So commonly known as rainforests of the sea, coral reefs are now under massive bleaching, which is attributed to which of the following reasons? Okay. So is it option A, which is your rise in carbon dioxide level, B, rise in temperatures of the sea, option C is both, which is A and B, and the last option is none of the above. So Okay, so I think you all are getting this right. Yes, it is C. Both contribute to the coral breaching. Okay, next question. Which are the flightless birds that are found on the continent of Antarctica? Okay, so your first option is masked booby. The second one is brown-headed gulls. Third is penguins. And the last one is cranes. Okay, so there's a spelling mistake in that. Just, yes, C. Okay, yeah. From the things listed below, which material takes indefinite years to degrade? Okay, so is it banana peels? Is it aluminium? Is it styrofoam? Or is it polyethylene tetraphthalate? So of your four options, which one do you think? Okay, the right option is C, styrofoam. Okay, yeah, we'll go on to the next question. Carbon dioxide dissolves in the ocean and dash is formed. This leads to a higher acidity, mainly near the surface, which has been proven to inhibit shell growth in marine animals and is suspected as a cause of reproductive disorders in some fish. So what is this compound? What is this known as? Is it bicarbonate compounds? Is it option B, carbonic acid? Is it option C, hydrogen compounds? Or none of the above? Okay, so your right answer is carbonic acid. Okay, we'll go on to the next one. Which of the following are the major greenhouse gases? So your options are nitrogen oxide and methane. The second one is sulfur dioxide and nitrogen. Third one is water vapor, carbon dioxide, methane, and ozone. And your last option is hydrogen and water vapor. So what are the, I think this one you all are getting mostly correct. It is indeed C, water vapor, carbon dioxide, methane, and ozone. Okay, let's go on to the next question. Okay, so we go on to the next level, and which is we're going to take a question on the green skills. Okay, indicative question on the green skills. So the first one over here, the Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change, Government of India launched an ambitious skill development initiative in 2017. This aims to train and orient youth to enable them to gain employment or take steps for self-employment. What is this initiative known as? Name it. Okay, so is it the National Environmental Science Fellows? Is it the National Forestry Action Program? Is it known as the Green Skill Development Program or the Biosphere Reserve Program? Okay. All right. Yes, it is indeed the Green Skill Development Program. Okay, we'll go on to the next one. Dash consists of environment-friendly methods of farming that allow the production of agricultural crops or livestock without damage to human or natural systems. It also involves preventing the use of chemicals so as to avoid the adverse effects to soil, water, and biodiversity. So your options are organic farming, sustainable agriculture, sustainable development, or sustainable lifestyle. Okay, so which is your option? Which is the right answer over here? Okay, the right answer is sustainable agriculture. Okay, yeah. Go on to the next one, next level now. So now students from, we are doing level 3 now. So 9 and 10 standard students, be all yours. These are questions for you now. So we'll take a few questions on the environment, section 1. Let's start. Okay. So which one of the following global agreements aim to conserve migratory species of wild animals? So is it the Ramsar Convention? Is it the Cartagena Protocol? Is it the Bonn Convention? Or is it the Vienna Convention? Okay. So... Okay, the right answer is the Bonn Convention. Okay, we'll go on to the next one. fluorinated gases such as hydrofluorocarbons, perfluorocarbons, sulfur hexafluoride, and nitrogen trifluoride also contribute to the greenhouse effect. What are fluorinated gases? So your first option is man-made gases. Second one is non-greenhouse gases. Third one is they are a family of gases containing fluorine. And the last option is both A and C. So what do you think the right answer is over here? Yes, it is both A and C. Okay, so we'll go on to the last, the third question over here. Earth receives solar radiation from the sun. Passing through the atmosphere, some radiation is absorbed by the Earth while some is reflected back to space. Now, when this exchange of incoming and outgoing radiation occurs, some of the radiation gets trapped by gases in the atmosphere, and this gives rise to, this creates, you know, dash. So what is the right answer over here? Yeah, okay, so this indeed is the greenhouse effect. Okay, we'll go on to the next question. Yeah, the Paris Agreement aims to keep a check on the overall increase in global temperatures. Which of the following was agreed upon in the Paris Agreement that came out of COP21 held in Paris in 2015? So look at your options carefully. The first one is to limit sea level rise to 3 feet above the current levels. The second one is to pursue a goal of 100% clean renewable energy. The third one is to keep global temperature rise well below 2 degrees above pre-industrial levels, and to pursue a path to limit the warming to 1.5 degrees. And the last option is to protect biodiversity and to end deforestation in the world's rainforest. So the right answer over here is option C. Okay, we'll go on to the next one. Okay, so just a minute, okay. Okay, in providing basic services, example, water supply, sewerage, urban transport to households, and build amenities in cities which will improve the quality of life for all, especially the poor and the disadvantaged, is a national priority of the Government of India. Therefore, in 2015, the Atal Mission for Rejuvenation and Urban Transformation, which is AMRUT, was launched to cater to the infrastructure creation that has a direct link with the provision of better services to people. Under which arm of the government in the scheme is functional? I'm sorry, you already got the answer. So the right answer over here is the Ministry of Urban Development. Okay, we'll go on to the next one. Section 2 on green skills for level 3. Okay, so the first question, technical skills, knowledge, values, and attitudes needed in the workforce to develop and support sustainable social, economic, environmental outcomes in business, industry, and the community are termed as entrepreneurial skills, green skills, self-management skills, information and communication technology skills. Are you able to see my screen? Some problem.
Hello?
Yeah. Just a second.
Slideshow is not happening actually.
Okay.
So just which is why we can see your answer also.
Yeah. Just a minute. Yeah. Okay, Taru, I'll just stop sharing my screen 1 second.
Do you want me to share?
Yeah, can you just share the screen? Level 3, yeah, on the first question of green skills.
Just a second.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah, so yeah, so the question is technical skills, knowledge, values and attitudes needed in the workforce to develop and support sustainable social, economic and environmental outcomes in business, industry and the community are termed as. So first option is entrepreneurial skills, second option is green skills, third option is self-management skills, and the last one is information and communication technology skills. Okay, so understand the question. I know you got the answer previously, but try and link it up nicely. So the right answer is indeed the green skills. Okay, so apart from giving you an idea of, you know, the structure and the format of the questions, also try and look at the type of content that, you know, we are passing on in this through the questions. So you will, you know, you can get an idea that you will need to prepare in a similar way. Okay, so we'll go on to the next question. The core skills identified as necessary for the green worker include which of the following? Here options are environmental awareness, the second one, which is willingness to learn about sustainable development, third one is decision making ability, and the last option is all of the above. So what do you think the right answer is? Okay, so the correct answer over here is all of the above. Okay, so with that, I think we close level 3 questions and we'll now move on to level 4. Okay, section 1. So let's go on to the first question. Which term is used to describe a type of pollination whereby pollen of plants is distributed by insects? Okay, so your options over here are hydrophily, the second one is zoophily, entomophily, or anemophily. So what is the right answer over here? Okay, so it is option C, entomophily. Okay, that is the right answer. We'll go on to the next one. Second question. Which crop is immersed in water during its growing period, leading to the emission of large quantities of methane into the atmosphere? Is it wheat? Is it maize? Is it rice? Or is it barley? Okay, so the correct answer over here is rice. Okay, let's go on to the next question. Question number 3. Thomas Malthus introduced a term to define the maximum population size of our environment can sustain indefinitely. So what is this term known as? Is it the carbon footprint? Is it known as the carrying capacity? Is it the ecological footprint? Or it's just none of the listed options? Okay, so the right answer over here is carrying capacity. Okay, go on to the fourth question. Considering the current pattern of overconsumption, individuals living in developed countries have in general, okay, dash ecological footprint than those living in a developing world. Okay, so would that be a lesser ecological footprint, a higher ecological footprint, more or less the same type of ecological footprint, or it's exactly the same, exactly proportionate? Okay, so what do you think the right answer is? Okay, the right one is a higher ecological footprint than those living in the developing world. Okay, we'll go on to section 2 now. Sorry, one more question over here. The giant panda and the distantly related red panda share characteristics of both bears and the raccoon. Of these, which is found in India in its natural habitat? Is it the giant panda? Is it the red panda? Both or none? Okay, so the right answer over here is option B, which is red panda. Okay, go on to the next one. The section 2, which you'll get questions on green skills over here. So the first question, as a new concept to reduce wastewater generation, a system is constructed in green buildings to retreat it and reutilize the same for secondary purposes. Now, what is the term used for people involved in planning and construction of such a system? is it water treatment workers, waste treatment workers, green building workers, or wastewater treatment workers? What do you think the right answer is over here? It is wastewater treatment workers. Okay, so coming to the last question. With the rising problem of scarcity of water, the need to build rainwater pits is increasing. There are specific cadre of people who are specialized to lay the plan and construct rainwater harvesting systems for collecting rainwater and reusing it in buildings. What are these people called? Okay, are they called electrical engineers or mechanical engineers, rainwater harvesting engineers, or renewable energy engineers? So what is the right answer over here? What do you think is the right answer? It is option number C, which is rainwater harvesting engineers. Okay, so with that, we close the quiz. We would like to wish you the very best for your exam. And if you have any queries, we would like to take it as Taru said, even with respect to the questions, you are more than welcome to type out any queries or doubts, whatever you have, that, or you know, whatever you want to share with us. Thank you so much. Over to you, Tanvi.
Thank you so much, Shivana, for sharing, you know, these indicative questions. I'm sure students must have got some idea on what type of questions are they going to answer in the examination. So with this, we now come to the question answer session. I would request, if any of you has any question related to the examination, may please raise your hand and we'll unmute you, and then we'll definitely give you a chance to speak on your question. And also for the ones watching us on YouTube, we request you to please post your questions so that we can even have a look at them, and then we can answer the same.
Tanvi, there are few common questions on the chat and Q&A box that are there. So I will just be speaking about a few such that, you know, we can answer to all of them in one go. So there are few common questions like, when will we get the examination link and username password? So just to answer to this question to all of you, that for the students who are appearing for examination in November, which is from 10th to 15th of November, you will be getting the examination link and username and password from today until 8th of November. Okay. And if you don't receive it by 8th of November, please feel free to write an email or call us. Yeah, our email ID is, please take down, it's geo@terry.res.in. Okay. For students who are appearing in December, your username and password and examination link will be shared in December itself, not before that. All right, I hope I have made myself clear. The students who are appearing in December, please do not log on to any link, because it will not work for you. Your respective portal plus your username password will be sent to you in first week of December. Then there are few questions on the quantity of the question. So as I told all of you in my PPT, there will be 50 questions for both the examination, for the ones who are appearing in November, and for the other December examination also, the number of questions will be 50. And there is another question on learning material and study material for the examination. So you know, Green Olympiad Secretariat doesn't recommend any curriculum. We always tell you to please go through your class, your books on geography, science, and history, and environment studies if you are studying it in your board. You should also be aware of the current affairs. You should also see sample questions that are there on our website. Plus, if you still think, you know, that your preparation is not sufficient, then you can go through Terry Bookstore to see if there are any books on quizzes. Okay.
Yeah, thank you, Tav. And there are a few students asking for the PPT also.
Sure, this PPT, the recording of the today's session will be available on YouTube, so you can refer back to the sessions again. And for the PPT, we will put it on our website. So if you want to go through the process, you can do it again. We will not be able to send it to individual students, but you should visit our website in a day or so, maybe tomorrow you can visit our website to see this PowerPoint presentation available on our webpage. Username, password, I said that you all will be getting separate emails from Green Olympiad Secretariat.
All right, and so, you know, there was one question on, you know, asking, he or she was asking whether we will be recorded while giving the examination. I mean, basically the monitoring thing. And whether the screen will be recorded when we'll be giving the answers.
We are trying to record the examination for students who will be appearing, because we don't want you to look for a different tab or a phone. We will not be sharing any details of it because of reasons which are very, very, personal when it comes to appearing for an examination. We will not be telling you how we would be monitoring. So we would just request you to also be true to your heart and appear for the paper. I know it is very easy to, you know, just look through your books and look through the other websites and appear for the examination. We will be monitoring you in some way or the other. Your teachers are also there with us. CBSE is also on board when it comes to this particular examination. So please try and be honest when you appear for the examination, because as examiners, we will come to know who is cheating and who is not cheating. So I will not get into the details as to how we are recording and how we are monitoring. You are being monitored, and you need to be very, very careful while appearing for the examination.
All right, and maybe the ones raising their hands, we can take two to three questions.
There are, Tani, there's another question which I am seeing on my screen is that, you know, they have, students have registered, and there is, students have registered and they don't remember their date and slot. So, ma'am, don't worry on that part, because once you will get the examination name, username and password, you will be getting the time, date and slot also along with instructions in that email. So please do not worry. It happens. Maybe the registrations must have happened in August, and there are quite, you know, there are possibilities that students may have forgotten their slots and dates. So it's completely fine. The mail that is going from Green Olympiad Secretariat will have all the details. Yeah, Tanvi, please go ahead.
Yeah, okay. So maybe we can take a question or two from the ones who have raised their hands. Okay, so Utsarsh Mishra, we are giving you, we are requesting you to unmute your mic, and then you can ask your question.
Yes, ma'am.
You have a question? You raised your hand.
Yes, ma'am. So I have a question. I don't know that email ID and password we will get along with the examination link.
Yes, that is what I told a couple of minutes back, that your examination link, your username and password and your date, time slot, you will get in an email from us. So which date have you chosen?
November.
Okay. So you will be getting your username, password, examination link, everything by 8th of November.
Okay.
So all the details will be there in that email.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you.
Thank you. Shreesha, Shri Krish, you also have a question. We have given you mic rights. Please go ahead. Srisha, you have a question? Maybe then we can move ahead with the other one. Aryan Kumar. Aryan Kumar, you have some question, you raise your hand.
Yes, I have a question.
Yeah, tell me.
That you told that there will be four difficulty levels. Will the question all be mixed? Like I am a participant of the level one. So can the question come from level two or level three?
What's your name? Sorry.
Aryan Kumar.
Aryan, the questions will not be mixed. If you are in class four, how can you appear for class eight? So only that level, class four, the level of your class will be available to you. So level one will be available to you, okay? Level two, three, four will not be visible to you.
Okay, otherwise I thought that there will be four examinations.
No, no, that is not possible. Only your level you will be appear, and there'll be 50 questions in your level.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, Srisha, are you there? Or maybe we can skip to other questions. Atulya Rai. Atulya Rai, we have given you mic rights. Please, you may please ask your question. Atulya, are you there? You want to ask some question? Okay, so we move on to next student, that is Misty Dabas. Misty, you have raised your hand. You have some question. Please unmute yourself and we...
Please do not hesitate. Do ask your questions. If not, we can move ahead.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Please go ahead.
Mama, I want to ask that you were talking about some YouTube links and that your email ID. Can you once type it in it in the chat box?
Sure, I will. I will. Just give me a second.
Thank you, ma'am, so much.
All right, Misty. Okay, so the last question, Ritika. Ritika, we have given you mic rights. You may please go ahead with your question.
Yes. If someone doesn't complete the 50 questions in the time limit given, so what will happen?
It's okay. If you are not able to appear for all the 50 questions, you can submit it. But I suggest, it's in your favor. You should still attempt all the questions because there is no negative marking.
Okay.
Yeah. And if, say, for example, your time is up and your examination is still pending, what will happen is once your time is up, it will auto submit. So don't worry ki are mera exam to chala gaya, maine submit nahi kiya, and where will it be? It will get stuck somewhere. Nothing of that sort will happen. Once your time is up, even if you have not submitted, it will be auto submitted.
Okay, so the last question, Tarun. This is Prapti. Prapti, you have some question?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, please go ahead.
Ma'am, the books can we get only from the Theory Olympiad, or can we get on any other websites such as some Amazon or Flipkart?
Prapti, as I said, we do not prescribe any books that you should buy anything for this examination. You should know the current affairs on environment and the knowledge that you get in your classroom sessions on science, on geography, Yeah, some bit of history is also there. So try to take information and knowledge from the existing material that you have. But if you still insist to buy books, that you are free to buy it from any platforms that you want to. There are a lot of quiz books that are available on Amazon, even Terry Bookstore is there. So just go through these platforms and you can buy books. But we would still insist that you should, you know, refer to your curriculum books and the current affairs on environment and sustainable development. Okay.
Okay, ma'am. Ma'am, I have one more question that if anybody has got the opportunity to get the trophy or medals, so we will have to come anywhere to get that?
No, you don't have to come for any trophies or medals. We will get in touch with you or your teacher and we will be sending it through courier. So we are not doing any on-ground events or, you know, prize distribution ceremony as of now, because of COVID-19 situation.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you.
Yeah, please go ahead.
Ma'am, that for joining this webinar, I was getting an email. So, ma'am, according with that joining webinar link, there was a YouTube link also for again see this webinar. I can
I will share that also.
Okay, ma'am, thank you.
Okay, yeah, so thank you, students, and also there are a few questions in the chat box for the sample paper. I would just like to add that there are, you know, a few papers that have been uploaded on the website, and they are such that they give you an idea on what kind of questions will be asked, as Ms. Shabana also took the session today. So similar questions have also been posted on the website. You can go and just have a look at them. So with this, thank you so much, students, for such, you know, interesting questions. And thank you, Taru, for answering all of them. I would now request Ms. Neha, fellow and area convener, environment education and awareness, Terry, to kindly deliver the vote of thanks. Over to you, Neha.
Thank you, Tanvi. Thank you, everyone. Thank you for attending our webinar on Green Olympiad Online Examination Learning Process. I really hope you enjoyed it. If your question wasn't answered during the live event, please don't get disheartened. We will get back to you, okay? You can even access the slides and recordings on YouTube. Taru ma'am has already shared it. Also, you can go on GEO website and refer to frequently asked questions, FAQ section, okay? Please feel free to pass these along to your friends and schoolmates who have registered for Green Olympiad. It is like you can share it with any of your friends, your relatives, siblings, and your schoolmates. Okay, I would also like to express my gratitude to all your students for your presence and contribution to make this webinar a great success. With this, I would like to thank my colleague Taru Mehta, who is also a project investigator of the project, for making an excellent presentation and answering all your queries. I would also like to express my gratitude to Dr. Livleen Carlon, Associate Director, for her presence in the webinar and guidance throughout the project over the years. A big thanks to my colleague Shabana and Tanvi for making this webinar interactive and fun and helping in sorting your queries related to Green Olympiad online examination process. With this, I would like to wish you all the best for the exam. Please use your upcoming festival break to both enjoy the festival and also do a little bit of reading on a regular basis. We can read now at least an hour daily on environmental issues so that we can perform well. And the students who are saying, what if someone does not score 100? We want all of you to score 100. It's just that you need to read. There is no standard reference books. It's just like, as Taru ma'am said, read your current affairs, read your books, you will get questions from your curriculum. So you can score 100% only if you wish like. So wishing you all a very best. And in case you feel that your some questions are still unanswered, feel free to write to us. Okay? Take care. Thank you, everyone.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Can you please open your camera? We need to have a group picture also. Jose, if you can give access to students for opening up the camera. And Mishti, yes, please go ahead with your question.
Ma'am, that you were saying for a website of this theory of for books, ma'am, we have to go on that website and we can read online after buying it, or we have to take the books from some place?
No, you should first visit the link. You will come to know what exactly, you will get there. Whether there are e-books or you'll have to buy physical copies, you'll get an understanding of it. Just go through the link. It's Terry Bookstore.
Okay, ma'am. Okay? Thank you.
Okay. Please open your video, everyone. The entire Geo team also.
Sorry, we cannot take the pictures for our participants.
All right, not an issue. But jitne bhi hain abhi screen par hum
unko. Ah, yeah, those who are not there taking their photo.
Yeah. Is Livleen there?
No, I think she's not.
Okay. Shabana, if you want to open your camera. We are very sorry for students who were not able to come on the camera. I can see sad smileys. Please don't get disheartened. The issues are such because the participants are around 400 and it is technically impossible to give access one by one to everyone.
That's correct. Okay?
But thank you so much for participating. It was lovely interacting with all of you and good luck for the examination.
Thank you so much, students, and wish you all the very best for the upcoming examination and wish you all a very happy and safe Diwali also.
Bye, everyone. Thank you.